Hi everyone, today we're talking technical SEO audits, and in particular we're looking at Semrush and why I've recently switched over to the Screaming Frog crawler. Let's jump on in and take a look at it. So I've been using Semrush for a long time, and it's great for keyword tracking, for its content writing tools, and I thought it was great for its audit. But then I just had this feeling something wasn't quite right with some of the results I was getting, so I tried out the Screaming Frog crawler, and when I did, it uncovered all sorts of cool things that I could improve on my site. Some of them weren't so cool because they were errors, but hey, I can at least find out about these issues and fix them. Particularly though, around images, around links, and around redirects. Let's jump on into this video, and I'm going to take you through the main areas that I found and how I could improve them using Screaming Frog. So let's take a look at the Semrush audit report versus Screaming Frog. So right now my site health on Semrush says 99%, and we're going to jump over to issues and scroll down, and we're going to get to the alt text area. It says here that zero images don't have an alt attribute. That's fine. That's actually correct. But what's in those alt attributes? Are they all populated or aren't they? And I was assuming that they were populated, but when I came and did the Screaming Frog report, I found that actually here we can see that the missing alt text says 73. So we have the attribute, there is zero there, but we have 73 items that do not actually have alt text. So I can go and take a look at one of those. And if we say open from in browser like that, and we're going to take a look at this image here, which is this one, and inspect it. And then when we look at the inspector, we can see it does in fact have an alt attribute, but the alt attribute itself is empty, and that's no good. So although we've got the alt attribute, it should actually have text inside it. When it comes to missing alt text within Screaming Frog, what we can do is copy our URL and then jump onto Chrome and go to our media libraries. This is the first place that you would go to be able to start editing your alt text. So here we had the download monitor URL. And if you paste the whole URL in, quite often it doesn't find it. So you just have to delete things down and take those ending and start parts off, and then it will find the image. And we can see here that this item doesn't have any alternative text, and that's why it's not pulling in to those various places that we're using it. We can see that it's got a link to the page that I've loaded it to, however. So this is an icon for the Premium Download Monitor plugin. So icon for Premium Download Monitor. If I add that to the alt text there, I can paste it into caption and description as well if I choose to. It's really up to you. Or we can also put it in the title as well if we want to, just like that. Now, as soon as you type these items in, they save. So by closing that, that item now has an alt attribute, and that will be fixed on pages around the website. When editing alt text from the media library, I've opened up this item here, and I've got next and previous icons up the top. This allows you to go to the next media item within the gallery. Here, you can see that this then allows me to edit that alt text quite quickly. So this icon restrict content pro is missing an alt text. So let me update that quickly. There we go. Click away, that is now saved, and that's one more alt text out of the way. Get to the next one, paste again. Save again, just like that. And we just keep on going through each item until everything has alternative text. There's a second place that we may want to look for alt attributes, and that's within the block editor itself. So if I go and edit this page, we'll notice when I click this particular image in the sidebar here, the alt text is empty, and that needs to be populated. So in some cases, you want this to be populated not out of the media library, but you may also want to customize it for a specific page. In this case, we're on our business class plans. So what I'm going to do is just copy business class plan, click on the image again, so it comes up, and just say support technician completing a business class care plan for WordPress. So that's a little bit of keyword stuffing there for you. But that's the kind of thing that you may want to do. I'm not condoning that. That is keyword stuffing. So if you've ever heard of keyword stuffing, that's it. I've just stuffed a image alt text with a whole bunch of keywords that aren't really descriptive for that image. But the point is you can customize the image in that location. Now, depending on the type of block it is, that may have alt text, it may not. So if I come down to here, to these items, cancel that for a moment, we'll notice that this particular block down here, it's a custom block. This one doesn't have alt text. If I scroll further down, we've got a standard image again that's missing alt text. And then when I come down further again, these don't have alt text because they're a different kind of block. So depending on the type of block it is, will depend if it's pulling, if it's got a customizable alt text in the block. If it doesn't have one, it'll be taking it from the media library. One of the benefits of Screaming Frog is the image crawler. And this image crawler goes through and looks at things like the size of my images. In this case, I've got an email alert icon here. And when I look at that, I can see that it's on my contact page. So when I go to the contact page, I've got this tiny icon here. And you wouldn't believe it, but it's loading a 2000 pixel version of that image. So what do I do? Well, I'm going to edit the page and take a look at this image. And when I look at it, all I can see is that in the sidebar here, under the Kadence Advanced Image block that I'm using for that icon, we can see that it has the full-sized image. And I'm just going to take that down now to be one of the smaller ones. We can use the thumbnail. And just make sure that that sizing is still correct there. So now it's going to load the thumbnail image instead, and I push update. When it comes to image names, we should be using lowercase, not uppercase, and they should be separated by hyphens for each word. Here you can see that I've got something just called featured image, which isn't a good name for the image. And when we look at it, we can see it's the what I bought this Black Friday from 2021. So what I want to be able to do is go into the media library and fix that. So let's go to media library. And here we've got the image, and what I'm going to do first and foremost is we need to deal with the file name itself. So I copy the URL to the clipboard, paste it, and then what I'm going to do is right click and say save image as. And then I'm going to say Black Friday 2021. Like that, I'm going to save it to my desktop, and it's a .jpg, so I'll put the extension on the end too, and go save. And we're going to say use.jpg. So we'll take the JPEG. And then I'm going to go back to my media library. And we're going to say add new. And we'll take a look at this file. And let's see if it's going to load. So now we can see that we've got Black Friday 2021. So I'm going to put some alt text in here. Now what I need to do is go to the article where that item is listed. So let's go back to our Screaming Frog, and here we can see where that's linked from. So I'm going to say open from in browser, and then I'm going to say edit the post. And this is the featured image. So down here, I'm going to say replace image. And we can see we've got featured image.jpg, which was loaded on the 30th. And then we've got this one here, which is loaded today. So I'm going to say set featured image, just like that, and say update. Go back to Screaming Frog. And because we can see that this was the only place that this was used, because it's got one instance on the number one there, we know that we can delete the old image. So now let's go to media library. And again, we're going to look for featured. And we're after this one here, which was called featured image. And then I'm just going to say delete permanently. Okay. That's now been cleaned up and the image has been replaced. When it comes to looking at Screaming Frog with all of your images, you can actually sort via this column called image links. And that tells you how often an image is used across your site. So for me, it's obviously my logos. The logos are used on every single page, but then there's other images as well. And this means that if you're going to replace an image, it's quite easy to be able to identify and say, which pages is this image on and where will I need to go and update it if I want to replace it. So here in the URL report, I noticed this area here that says repetitive path in the chart down here, and I had one repetitive path. I've not seen that in my other audit report, so I took a look at it and realized that I have this URL here that says mrkwp.com/guide, FAQ plugin guide. If we look at that URL, we can see that guide is repeated, so it says it's got a repetitive path. So let's open this up. And we'll see here, this is the page, and it says guides, FAQ, FAQ plugin guide, but in the URL here, we can see that in fact, that's correct. It's got that problem. So what I'm gonna do is edit this guide. It's a custom post type that we have on the MRK website called guides. So what I need to do is edit this to change the permalink. So we're gonna call that instead FAQ guide, like so. Push return there. So that's what it's going to be now. That's good. And then I'm going to go update. And this is also going to create a redirect for me. So the old URL to the new one, and I go okay. So I'm using Yoast Premium, which created that redirect for me. You can also use the redirection plugin to do that. That's how we fix up that repetitive path issue inside a Screaming Frog. Okay, so inside the redirect list, I look at response codes, and I've got internal redirects with three X's. And these are pretty much a big problem when it comes to WordPress sites because they can be hard to find. So I'm gonna check on my end links. And some of these I know what they are. So the MRK admin, these author redirects, they're fine. That's a bug in a plugin that I'm aware of. This here, however, that's a problem. That WP there, that doesn't look real good. And it's redirected four times. So if I look at this and open this up, first of all, I'm gonna open up where is this redirect actually going to, okay? So let me say open to in browser, and that is going to guide WP engine for WordPress administrators, and it shouldn't be going there. It should actually be going to my products page. We used to have our top level products page just be WP, now it's WP products. So I go to my redirects inside Yoast. This is a premium tool. You can also use redirection, or you can use something on your server. So what I want to do here is paste in the new URL, and the old one out of Screaming Frog was just WP. So I'm going to say copy that, go back here like that, and say add redirect. And that redirect has been successfully added, but what I'm going to do is use a temporary redirect. The reason why I do that is while I'm going through my redirects, I want to make sure that things aren't cached, and I want to make sure that they're going to go to the right spot. So you can see there that has now gone to the correct place, WP redirects, because that redirect has pushed into the right spot. So that's one win. We've got my redirect going to the right spot right now. The other problem that we've got is, of course, that this redirect is still inside these pages. Let's go through here. And we can see right there that all various products, that link is going to the wrong spot. So I'm going to copy my new link. That's where it should be going. And then I'm going to go and edit this page. And inside of here, just going to click on there, click edit, paste in my new URL. And that's now correct, and click update. And that's now saved. So an internal redirect is often a problem because you're linking to something that you're then redirecting. From here, I'll go ahead and edit the rest of those links, and that's how we use the internal redirection tool within Screaming Frog. So this is the over 561 pixels for your page title. So page titles are really important because that's what shows up inside search engines. So we're going to take a look at our services page right here, where I can see the length is exactly 565 pixels. We need to reduce it just slightly. So let's take a look at that inside the browser. This is the page here, and when I put my mouse over the top, we can see, yes, this is WordPress websites and search engine optimization, MRK WP. And we need to just reduce that just a little bit. So we're going to say edit page. And from there, we're going to scroll down and get to the Yoast area within the editor. And here we have Yoast SEO Premium, and here's my editor just here, showing me a preview of what my listing looks like. And just below there, we have the WordPress SEO title that we're looking to be editing. So I'm just gonna take out those items just there, So WordPress Websites and SEO Service Agency, that's much better. And we can see here while I'm at it, I've got my meta description, and that's too long as well because I've got the orange bar there. So I'll just leave it at that for now. That looks pretty good. And we can see that now that's looks a lot shorter. It'll look a lot better within the results. And we can see there that I don't need MRKWP anymore because that's inside the branding of the search results. So within Screaming Frog, I also like this content tool. What it does is tell you a word count, sentence count, how easy something is to read, and allows me to sort my content via those parameters. And when I look at this one, there was of course this giant green bar in the content area with low content pages. And all of these ones here, as we can see, have a low word count. So it makes it really easy to identify, okay, these need to be improved. The other one I liked was the readability difficulty. And we can see here with the Elementor support page that we have a readability difficulty issue. So it gives me some quick tips to very quickly go and improve content, both in length and how easy something is to read. Well, I hope you all loved that video. I certainly enjoyed making it. There was so much that I've learned, and there's a lot more that I've learned as well from the Screaming Frog crawler. If you want to know more about technical SEO audits, whether from Semrush or from Screaming Frog, why don't you leave a comment below about what you would like to see, and I'll make a video about it. Now, of course, if you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I hope to see you in my next video.